And today we're going to interview our students Ayush and Nazir, who are placed in Accenture with a 12 LPA package for the role of Advanced Application Engineering Analyst. अब आयुष हमारे अल्फाबेट स्टूडेंट हैं एंड नज़ीर हमारे डेल्टा एंड अल्फाबेट स्टूडेंट्स हैं. आज हम इन दोनों स्टूडेंट्स की कंप्लीट टेक प्लेसमेंट जर्नी के बारे में डिटेल में जान रहे होंगे.
यू कैन लेट अस नो व्हाट योर नेम इज, व्हिच कॉलेज डू यू कम फ्रॉम, व्हिच ईयर ऑफ कॉलेज यू आर इन, एंड वेयर हैव यू गॉटन प्लेस्ड एंड एट व्हाट प्रोफाइल. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद नज़ीर.
Good evening, ma'am. First of all, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to you and Raman sir. I had no clear direction and spent most of the time browsing YouTube. And then on a fine day, I have seen a video of Raman sir, where sir has launched DSA in C++. It mainly consists of 260 videos. And using it, I learned DSA and it really helped me to grab this opportunity, ma'am. And coming about myself, I'm Nazir. I'm coming from Visakhapatnam and recently I've completed my final year from Amrita Vishwavidyapeetham Chennai campus. And I got placed at Axis Institute.
I am from NIT Kurukshetra, finally electrical engineering student, and I also placed in Accenture. That is why I thank you so much, ma'am, for the platform.
Congratulations to both of you for getting placed. Ayush, you tell us about the entire interview process that you went through for Accenture. What was round one, what was round two, round three, and so on. Tell us in detail. And if you can also recall the kind of questions they asked you, you can also let us know about that.
Okay, so basically, ma'am, there are three main rounds. First round is like online assessment. It consists of two sections. First is quantitative aptitude, reasoning, English comprehension, and second is coding, right? So like the first part of the round, if we clear, then only we get the coding round, opportunity to solve the DSA question. So in quantitative, there are like five sections, and we were given 1 hour time. And if we qualify that round, then there were two questions of DSA. And I said that was like easy to medium question, and 40 minutes was the time. And whoever solved in like least time, like both the questions in 20 minutes or in 30 minutes, they were going further in the second round, which was a communication round, which it was not non-eliminatory. It was non-eliminatory round. First one was eliminatory and it was gone. And after like completing the communication round, there were a shortlisting of 140 students for personal interview. And in personal interview, it was HR plus technical, like a single interview round. And in that, it will last for like 45 minutes interview, like 30 to 45 minutes. And they will ask some technical question regarding our projects, our final year project. I was still on my final year project. And our internships, the languages that we know, basic OOPS concepts, basic computer networks questions. And after that, they will stress on HR interviews, HR type questions, like what are the challenges that you faced, how you will solve the conflict in a team. And I was asked also, like, what was the biggest challenge in my internship period? So these type of questions were asked. And after like completion of these three rounds, after 12 days, we got the list of like selected students. So This was it.
Okay. And what about you, Nazir? Was it a similar process?
It's almost similar.
Okay. So you had the same rounds in the same order.
Yes, ma'am.
So can you also tell us about the level of DSA questions that were asked in the first round?
Very easy. Like I solved both in nearly 5 to 7 minutes.
Okay. So it was easy level questions which were asked. Do you also remember the particular question which you guys solved?
Yes, I do remember. The one question was, we need to use two pointers. Like basically, it's the sum of two numbers in optimal way.
Okay.
Yeah, and the other one is the stock span problem.
Okay. And what about you, Ayush?
I got a greedy algorithm question, like chocolate dividing question, chocolate division question. That was the second question. First question was the basic sorting question. Like after sorting, we have to do some operations.
Okay, both of you are coming from two different ends of India. One is from North India, one is from South India. And can you also describe about what was the CGPA criteria or the branch criteria to sit for Accenture?
Ma'am, like there was not very strict CGPA criteria, like 60% in 11th, in 10th and 12th, and 6.5 CGPA, like which is not very harsh. But coming to the selections, when there are so many applications, then CGPA plays an important role. Like you will be eligible, but for the case of consideration and selection, if we have a good CGPA, that helps. So
okay. And what is your CGP? What is your current GP?
Ma'am, right now I'm managing like 8.7037, kind of 8.7. Yeah.
Okay. And what about you, Nazir?
8.5.
And what was the criteria in your college? Same criteria. And were all branches allowed?
Yes, ma'am. All branches were allowed.
Okay. And can you also give us an estimate of how many students got shortlisted for this particular profile in Accenture in your college?
Vendor selection, ma'am. Around 90, ma'am.
90.
Across four campuses of Amrita. Like we have four campuses.
Four different campuses.
Yeah. From all the campuses, around 90 people were selected.
Okay. And what about you, Ayush?
We have 30 students, like in the final selections.
Okay. And Ayush, can you mentioned that you already had a prior internship experience. Can you also describe about that experience where you did your internship?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I got my internship through reaching out people. So, through LinkedIn, because in 2024, there are not many, so many opportunities on campus. So, I tried and I got internship in a Century Plywoods India Limited. So, there was I was working as a web developer and automation scripting intern. So I used to work on Python scripts for task automation, like email extensions automation and this kind of things. Yeah, so that was part of it, internship, and I also learned React, Django kind of text like there.
Okay. And can you also both describe to us, like apart from the placement, what kind of projects did you have in your resume? So we'll start with Nazir. Nazir, what projects did you explicitly mention in your resume?
While doing projects, I came across some videos. Like I know that most of the people were copy pasting the same thing, and majorly everyone will have the same projects in their resume. You all will say that we need to observe a problem and then you need to quote a solution for it. Then only your project will have a value in your resume. Mm. So we all know that we will be studying to exams only one night before. And also in our college, we have strict rules that we are not given access to previous year question papers and all, even though we are having in library. So I proposed a solution, like we'll have a website for this. We can host our papers and also any capstone projects which you are doing, so that it will be helpful for our juniors also. If anyone is preparing one night before exam, they will be knowing whatever the questions are frequently being asked in this particular topic, and based on that, they will be preparing. And also, if you're going to do some projects in this particular course, they will be knowing that what the seniors did, and on top of that, they can add some value to that project. So I've designed a website using one stack where people can collaborate and they can upload their resources. And I also followed some security protocols, like only the students from Amrita can upload. We'll be having college email ID, right? So based on that. And the other project is a canteen. Same in our college, we'll be having a canteen, and most of the people will be forming queues and all. We'll be having only 10 minutes break, and we are supposed to return to the class on time. And also there is an issue of inventory management and all. So we observed that, and we developed an app where we plan to have admin analytics dashboard, so that admin will be knowing on which days, which menu can be, like the quantities of a particular item can be having. And that's it, those two projects.
So that is a really good approach. You identified a lot of problems inside your campus and you built tech solutions for that. Great. What about you, Ayush? What kind of projects did you mention?
Ma'am, like from second year after, like I was too much interested in development. So I started doing freelancing and all. So in my resume, there was a like project, freelancing project, which was hosted on Play Store. Like it's a Flutter plus Firebase app, and it was hosted on Play Store and having 1,000 plus downloads. So that also worked really good. It was a matrimony app which was having users. So due to having like real users, it was shining in my resume. And coming to my personal projects, like I also like to do like real life problem solving. So as I mentioned, I was working in Python scripting and automation part. So like in our college, what happens whenever mid-sem or end-sem exams come, there is so much traffic on the like Wi-Fi, and internet goes very slow. Like we are not able to watch like YouTube lectures or any other resources. So I wrote a script, Python script, for downloading a complete playlist. Like there was a front end on React where we can paste the playlist link. Whatever, like if I want to learn C++ or Java lectures, I will paste the link of the playlist and I will get the complete videos. And on a single click, I can download videos in my laptop. And we can also download single videos. So yeah, this was one of my projects. And learning projects, I also built real estate web applications on MonStack. There was a hackathon project in our college that was like the auto rickshaw services. In our college, we designed a system so that multiple students can share an auto, and the fare can be divided. So these 2-3 projects work really good for me.
Okay, great. Can you describe more about the Matrimony project and how did it get real users?
Yeah, so actually in second year, through our senior, we got a local client from Haryana. So we had a 3-member team. We used to do hackathons together. So we got the project. Now, at the time, I didn't knew about Flutter and all like cross-platform technologies. So I designed the application like Matrimony, all the screens from Figma. So I was getting also used to convert a real Figma design into a application. So I converted that app into Figma, and we as backend service, as it was a very small scale startup, so they don't want they wanted a backend as a service, not to hire a big team to like manage the backend, so that they can whenever services are not up to that, they will increase the charges on Firebase and they can scale that. So we designed backend completely on Firebase. And that is why I also built so many projects in Firebase afterward. And mainly I designed the Flutter part. Yeah, Dart programming and all that.
So let's start with you, Nazir. What did you prepare in terms of placements and internships or study in your first, second and third year before you got the offer?
In the first year, I studied DSA basics and all. I not started trace. I studied up to linked list and recursion. And in my second year, I studied linked list trace. And also, I've practiced CP on PortsF and LeetCode. And in my third year, I focused on projects and all. The second year and third year, we'll be having a break, right? In the break and 2-3 months, I have learned Merge Stack and I've done 2 projects.
Okay.
That's good.
Okay. And what about you, Ayush?
I started programming little late. In my first semester, I was preparing for J Advanced back again. To take a partial draw. And then in my second semester, in first semester, I also maintained good CGPA. I know CGPA plays a good role, plays a role. So CGPA was good. Then in second semester, I saw people doing programming and I also got interested. So I started with web development because starting with DSA sometimes becomes a little boring. I was not getting interested very much. So I started with web development and in hackathons I participated. After that, I used to do random problem solving. There's some DSA questions, some basic sorting questions. I had only 50 or 60 questions on LeetCode. But some of my seniors guided me that, yeah, DSA plays an important role in complete placement. Every company come, they will ask, they will give OA. And if you can't pass the OA, you will not even get the interview. So DSA is important. So I started doing DSA. But then what happened, I there was so much random content here and there. So I thought to get a, because in my curriculum, there is no DSA. I'm from electrical engineering, so there is no DSA. So I need a structured way, what topics to study, from where to study, what are the questions. So then I decided to join and I was watching Apna college from, Apni Kaksha from school time. So I watched that video, Apna college is launching a batch. Then I joined Alpha 2 batch. And from that, I did all the topics greedy trees, completely up to segment trees and all advanced topics. And then I started doing LeetCode rigorously. I didn't did very much, did CP very much because, I was doing so much LeetCode only. So through that, when I completed the course, there were 250 questions on my LeetCode. So I was I was very happy to see that count. Yeah, I'm improving. So I started giving contests and I rigorously did only LeetCode. In competitive programming, I attempted few contests on Coursera. That's only I'm 3-star. They are not very big achievement there, but I'm doing LeetCode right now. I'm doing LeetCode because it's really interesting to solve that POTD questions. And I also decided that until my placements, I will do maintain the streak. So I maintained a 365 days streak on LeetCode. And yeah. That helped me very much because I completed the topics and I solved rigorously, so my topics became strong.
Let me also know the one mistake that you have committed in your placement journey that if given a chance, you would not like to repeat again.
Ma'am, I was talking about, I started a little late that I cheated. That I should have started doing DSA so much. And yeah, the competitive programming is really important for the online assessment part, because nowadays online assessment the questions are really like from advanced topics like fit manipulation, FMV trees, segment trees type of questions are also there. Some good DP questions are there. So yeah, I feel that I should have done CP like more and started earlier.
So Nazir, what was the role of Alpha and Delta in your journey?
Whatever I am today, it's because of the Alpha and Delta element. Because I learned everything from here on.
Okay. Thank you.
And also I've suggested these courses to all of my friends. But sadly, no one is interested to take it because they are not that much interested into placements. They came into college just to have fun and all. That's it. So one or two people have taken Delta beds.
Okay. Are they liking it?
Yes, ma'am. They also got placed. Mm-hmm. And they are also doing some internship. And they messaged me that thank you for suggesting this course because it's really added a value to us. And also whatever they are doing now in the internship, they learn those skills from Delta only, the developments.
Congratulations to them too. And what about you, Ayush? What was the role of Alpha?
Ma'am, like in my journey, the complete structure, like what topics to study, I was clueless, like studying here and there and not getting a solidified knowledge. So from Alpha, I got the structure that, yeah, these are the topics that I need to learn first. Then I can only jump into lead coding. And I can remember like, there was some advanced topics that are not on YouTube very much, like in good extent. So some of my friends together, we also watched with a single laptop that this is the topic. So yeah, that was a great great memory that I had. And Alpha played really a great role in my life also, that I actually studied all those topics before the placement season. Otherwise, I would have regretted that I didn't study. Yeah.
How much time did you dedicate to your aptitude preparation? Did you take out some time or did you not prepare for aptitude at all for the rounds?
Actually, when I got to know that the first round, aptitude round, is the eliminatory round. So I thought doing aptitude is easy, but doing in a short amount of time, we have to know the tricks for that. So I only watched for 2-3 days, I watched all the tricks videos of aptitude, like what are the tricks for river boat problem, what are the formulas of that. So I revised all that. And also there was a PDF file for aptitude revision in Alpha 2 that I also referred for preparing my aptitude and reasoning. So tricks are really important to know for calendar problem, for relationship problems. So yeah, so I learned only the tricks and I then attempted the paper and went really good.
Okay. So is there anything else that you would like to tell us about your entire placement preparation journey that you want to add on?
Starting with me, ma'am, placement journey, it's like it's completely never give up type of thing, because given any holiday for preparing for placement, right? There are classes going on and we are giving OAs. Sometimes we are getting selected, sometimes we are not getting selected. And after 2-3 OAs are not going good, we literally feel demotivated that are we learning right thing? Sometimes we start questioning our career choices also, that yeah, we can do something else also, we can sit for four companies as well. So that was also a case, but still I remain strong that I will do coding, and because I had interest in development and all. So I continued and I kept being consistent in the complete journey. And the YouTube and the online study, I am very used to with it, because I prepared JEE also through studying online. I studied Aman Bhaiya's 12 hours long courses, classes that he used to take from morning to night. So I was very used to it, online learning. So that helped me very much, because I always learn online. So in placement, that helped very much. And that is the main thing, that we have to keep being strong and manage all the things. Time management, being strong and learning new things is always important for a good placement.
So we wish you all the best. And I'm sure that a lot of students, a lot of juniors will be watching this interview and they will get inspired and they'll also work hard towards their goals. It was really nice to talk to you, both of you. And your words are going to create an impact on a lot of students who are coming up and who have similar goals as you. So thank you so much for your time today. And
thank you
for your time. Thank you, guys. And bye-bye.
Bye. It was a nice conversation, man. I literally, it was really, really a dream to getting one-on-one interaction with you. Thank you so much for that.
Same here, and it was really nice interacting with both of you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Ayush. Thank you, Nazir.